Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will introduce a new capability which allows you to retrieve and import resources that are deployed to an integration server. Capability was added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.8. I will use the same scenario as my previous video, where I send a HTTP message to a message flow. The message flow will send a REST request to a backend REST API. The REST API returns a population estimate for a European city that was entered in the original message. A stack request node is used to indicate if the REST request was successful or if it failed. And a response is sent from the message flow, which shows the population estimate if the REST request succeeded. So I have connected to two integration servers. One integration server contains the message flow, which I'll send the message to, and the other integration server contains the backend REST API. I'm going to send a message to the flow, and in the body it has country code on Germany. And when I click send, I can see that an error has been returned. I'm seeing 404 not found. So I can also see in the Slack channel that there is a message which says an error has occurred and no response was received from the country API. So I sent this message to the URL localhost :7800/demo_retrieve. In the previous video, I showed at the integration server level, you can now see a list of the transport endpoints, and if I select the URL that I sent the message to, which was demo_retrieve. I can see it is using the application demo_app_retrieve, and in there it has a message flow called demo flow. So new in 12.0.8, you can either double click on the flow or right click and select view message flow. And if you select that option, you see the message flow, which is shown in the message flow editor. It is a read-only view. You get an immediate visual understanding of what the message flow is doing, and you can see the flow properties, and you can see the live node values as well. So this allows me to familiarize myself with the message flow and do some problem determination. So I've selected the REST request node here, and I can see that there is no base URL override set on the message flow node. However, I can see that there is a compute node before the REST request node, and I suspect that it is setting the base URL override value in that compute node. So I need to check the contents of that compute node. And new in IBM App Connect Enterprise 12.0.8, you can now select the integration server level a new menu option, which is Retrieve and Import Resources. Now, notice that I have no applications or message flows in my workspace at the moment. Okay, I just have some bar files and a test server. So if I select this option, I can see a new wizard here, which allows me to select an application and one or more policy projects. So I'm going to select the demo_app_retrieve application, and I'm going to select the Slack policy project as well. And when I click next, I can see the resources that belong to the application, and they will be imported into the workspace. So if I click finish, I can now see the application and the policy project has been imported. I can see there is a message flow, a map, and eSQL files as well. And I can open up the message flow, and I am able to see the configured properties. I can use the flow exerciser to recreate the problem. So if I select the integration server and redeploy the flow, if I put a message through the flow using the same message as before, so country colon Germany, and click send, I can see the same error that I was seeing before, which is the 404 not found. And as before, I am seeing the error message in Slack as well. So now I can see the path that was taken through the message flow. And if I select the message assembly after the REST request node, I can see that under the local environment destination, the base URL was set to country API/v0. So I can check the URL that is required by the REST API. And if I select the second integration server and look at the transport endpoints, I can see that it is actually expecting country API/v1. I could also see the same information in the web UI. So if I select the endpoints tab in the web UI, I can also see the transport endpoints as well. And here it tells me that it is expecting country API/v1. So I need to understand why the REST request is using country API v1. If I have a look at the message assembly before the REST API, I can see that in the local environment under destination, I can see that the base URL is being set to country API/v0. So I can conclude from that it is being set in the compute node. So if I come out of record mode and open up the compute node, I can see the eSQL here, and sure enough, I can see that the wrong base URL is being used. It is using country API/v0. If I change that so that it is now v1 and save it, if I now go back and put a message through the flow exerciser, I'll have to redeploy since I changed the flow, and now I can put a message through, put the same message as before, and click send. I can now see that I've received the response from the backend REST API, which tells me the population estimates for Berlin. So in this video, I've shown that a new capability has been provided in 12.0.8, which allows you to retrieve and import resources which are deployed to an integration server. So this capability is useful for problem determination and for recovering resources that might have been lost. It is also useful for customers who are migrating to version 12 and need to check the resources that are deployed.